Okay, so, alluvial fan attempt number one. This attempt, we decided to try and see if we had, at a slight incline, just flat sand with a cliff at the end, to see what type of alluvial fan we could create and what path the water would choose to flow. This was also kind of an attempt to see what erosion would happen on a flat surface over time, with obstructions in the way, such as large areas of rock, anywhere from a boulder to entire mountain ranges. As the water flowed down, you can see the sediment erosion coming from behind the objects that we threw in there, which was just pebbles and sand that we were having the water flow around. But you can tell how it creates different features in the landscape, and you can imagine as a large scale over a long period of time, this could create channels that water could throw go really fast through, picking up a lot of sediment, and then that slowdown would deposit. This is how we create an alluvial fan. And so in later videos, we're going to show what this alluvial fan may have looked like in the Mars crater. This is our video of our first attempt at creating an alluvial fan, post-flow. So, now you can see where the water has created channels in here and how the different obstructions in the water's pathways have created channels and other features which are similar to an alluvial fan, but not quite what we would see on Mars and what we're looking at as far as how this alluvial fan in the crater formed. But this does give us an idea of how objects will, how the water reacts with the objects around them, and how we can now formulate an idea on how to create a crater and the alluvial fan going through the crater so that we can get the most accurate description of what it would be on Mars and how we believe that this has been created.
So, based on the basic structures and formations of craters, in which case you have a deeper lip on the right, on the outside of the crater, and more built up on the inside, as well as the rim of the crater, which would have to be broken through in order to create a river to form through there. We've created this as a simulation of what might have happened on Mars. We will now add water to see if that shall work. So as you can see, the water built up behind and then created erosion right here and created a factor of a more of a canyon and spread out and created this alluvial fan inside the crater. Now, considering that the table was at an angle, it brought it more down towards the bottom and didn't make it as wide, but as the crater on Mars would be more flat, it would have spread out a little bit more just by the topographical location of where the water would be coming through. This is an example of an alluvial fan and water erosion, and just kind of gives us an idea of how this could have worked on Mars.
This is our last attempt at trying to create an alluvial fan. We did this one over a period of 3 days because alluvial fans are not going to be made in a matter of seconds on Mars. They're going to take thousands of years, if not more than that. So we had to let this one run over the weekend, and we had a very slow amount of water going through it at all times. And then towards the end of the weekend on Sunday, we came by the school and we put some color into it, some dye, dropped some dye into it to just see a little bit more clearly how the alluvial fan looks and the ways that the water would flow and how it was affected by the water. Thank you.
just a small town girl, living in a lonely world. She took the midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit.